man in motion. Throws over the middle, charred loose. My goodness. Jaden Boysen with a punishing blow. There is a fly. A little bit of a high snap. Nice head fake. First down, second effort, stretching it. The ball came loose. South Alabama has it. They're going to call it a touchback. He fumbled it into the end. The Damian Webb, big burst, finds a hole. Good step to the outside. Got another block. Downfield by Boysen. Cotton Lacey with a block. Webb short of the end zone. Up the middle. Handoff. Touchdown. Drifting under it. Zuhl. Oh, and he gets hit high. Trey Kaiser, starting linebacker. He loves special teams, too. Two receivers left, two tight ends right. Five-step drop. That ball may be intercepted. Did he stay in bounds? Keith Gallman? Or is that Yam Banks? From inside the red zone. The give. Webb, left side, five. Count it down. Touchdown! 13-yard touchdown scamper. The Jags in possession, up seven. Bullock finds a hole. Bullock hit at the goal line. He's in. Touchdown! Kentrell Bullock.
The best local players to stay at home.
Kentrell Bullock's the running back. They throw it to Lacey. Crossing the middle, 25. Turns it up 30-40. He's loose at midfield. Looking for a downfield block. Cotton Lacey turning it back to the inside. 84 yards. Touchdown, South Alabama. Comes in for Bullock. He'll take the handoff, bounces outside, switches hands, 10, 5, dives inside the pylon. Touchdown! Barco Lee from 13 yards out.
Happy to get in the win column, our first home opener. Very excited to see our fans in Hancock Whitney Stadium. That was really great. I thought the student section showed up, which was awesome. Brought some really good energy, all that. You know, pregame stuff, really fun. Did not produce nearly well enough in the first half. Thought team seemed like we were playing, you know, with a bit of a hangover. And in terms of some of the things execution-wise, particularly in the passing game on defense, not executing enough offensively to sustain drives. But we got to give ourselves more than four drives in the first half if we want to score points. So some things that we certainly need to get cleaned up in the passing game. We've shown that we can stop the run defensively. Execution and intermediate passing game is critical. And then not letting people behind you, which we did 2 weeks in a row. Now, each of those have to be judged case by case, but certainly some things that we've got to get cleaned up if we want to reach our potential as a football team.
Questions?
It seemed like you guys were keeping the ball in front of you on defense instead of getting them behind you like last week, but still couldn't get off the field.
I thought there were two plays, you know, that we potentially let. One that we could have let them behind us, the other one we did, actually three, two that we let them behind us there for explosive plays. But I thought they did a good job in some of their intermediate passing game, forcing us to make some space tackles. And we had certain guys that did not make those space tackles. And so those things need to get cleaned up. Some of that is anticipation. You keep the ball in front of you, but you got to do a great job of breaking and driving. You know, we're often a vision coverage team, which means that we rally to the ball when the ball is thrown. And I did not think that we had that to consistency tonight at the point of attack. We would miss, you know, a 6-7 yard hitch route, right, that would go for a first down, or we'd get them behind the sticks. We got to do a better job in some of those things. So those are the things that when I look at off the field on third down and then certainly in the red zone, we got to find a way to capitalize. Gave up a little pop pass there. Some things at the end of the game. Obviously, you've got some young guys in there. You're going to have some of those mistakes, but those young guys, you know, it's an experience where they got to show that we can put you in at the end of a game and you can go execute. And certainly we did not do that defensively.
the ability to create turnovers and have momentum off of those turnovers. Talk about that for the second week in a row, being able to have turnovers.
Yeah, creating some takeaways on defense. You know, those things are positive. You know, we've got to continue to do that. You know, when you can stop the run, when you can rally to the ball, but in tight games, you know what I mean, you're going to have to create some field position, right? And takeaways on defense are a huge piece to field position. Didn't get the final number yet on where our average field position started, but did not think it was great. You know, thought we gave up some really good opportunities when we had them backed up and let them drive the length of the field. And so creating takeaways, you know what I mean, is a critical piece in flipping the field. But we got to do a better job of executing on third downs to get off the field so that we can maximize that that field position battle.
So the plan to rest Webb or use him sparingly or what? I mean, because when he got in there, obviously it looked good.
Yeah, he looked really good. We just we wanted to make sure, you know, Kentrell did a great job, you know, last week. And so we were going to try to start and get him off. He had something that kept him from the first couple plays of the game, but the intent was to start Kentrell off, and then we wanted to just make sure that LaDamian, you know, is getting reps that are manageable, you know, for, you know, a guy that has not taken as many reps in fall camp. You got to just kind of ease him in, and so we felt like we wanted to make sure that we kind of eased him in, and I thought we did exactly that, and he produced at a high level. So kid's a special player, man. Guy's a special player. And so really proud of how he has pushed himself and his body over the last few weeks here.
A lot of things to clean up, but at the same time, you're cleaning up from a win standpoint as opposed to last week. How much easier does that make preparation this week, just a little weight off the shoulders?
Yeah, I mean, I probably got to remind myself of those things as much as anybody. Standard's the standard, and all I can see is playing to the standard or not. So, you know, wins are what matters, right? At the end of the day, you got to win football games. You got to do your job over and over again to get to the point of winning. But you know, for me, to maximize this team's opportunity, I still don't think we're playing to the standard that we are capable of. And ultimately, that's our job as coaches, to make sure that we can play to the standard, right, and play to our potential, which I think we've played, you know, a game and a half now where we have not done that. And so those are the things that I'll be most focused on. Proud of the win for sure, but certainly good teams get better. They don't stay the same, and we got to continue to work on the things that we did not do well enough in this second game. Don't know yet. You know, walked off the field, but we'll take a look at him and kind of see. I'll get an update probably here later on this evening, and then we'll kind of take it from there based off of what our docs saw.
I mean, that's kind of part of the new rules. Kind of work with them, but yeah, off to a slow start offensively. That first series, 3 and out. You know, just got to be better in that. Making a better decision on that that second down. I got to get to my read faster, but you know, we'll learn from it, move on.
You guys did seem to turn it on when you needed to. I mean, you take anything good out of that?
Shout out to the O-lineman for the run game. I mean, you know, got to run the ball there in the second half efficiently. You know, the backs got to see some pretty holes there, so credits to them.
The touchdown to Lacey, what'd you see? I know he did a lot of the work.
Yeah, hey, the easiest 6-yard completion I think I've ever had in my life. But, yeah, got the look that we wanted coming off of the sideline. It was zone coverage. Kentrell did an unbelievable job at, you know, flaring and getting his man out of there. But yeah, Colin did, you know, most of the work there. So, and shout out to DJ Thomas with the downfield block. So,
to get the win, kind of get that, okay, let's breathe and let's play.
Yeah.
What does that do to get number one underdog?
Yeah, it's huge. Getting that first one in any win is hard in college football. And anywhere I think you play in all sports, it's hard to get wins. But get that first win, it's huge for, you know, the guys in that locker room, the coaching staff, and now it's just, you know, can we be consistent next week and do the same things that we need to do and clean up the things that we're supposed to do.
First half, I had a couple balls. I won it real bad. I got a little frustrated, but I had to get out of there and keep playing, and things happened in the second half.
TD pass, which is, by the way, the longest in South Alabama history. What did you see on the play? You just kind of ran with
it. I just seen green grass, and I was just playing football. Just backyard football, waiting on my block. Everybody thought I was jogging or thought I stepped out of bounds. I was just waiting on my block for DJ. I appreciate DJ. I owe him.
Uh,
What was the difference offensively? Guys, team to finally exhale and just start playing.
We just started playing ball. We stopped overthinking and just running back started running. And receivers started catching and getting yards. We just had to play football and stop thinking too much.
I'd like to see Webb come in there. He just kind of came off the bench and, you know, from there on, seemed like you guys were pretty dominant. What was it like seeing him come
out? Yeah, it was good. His first two touches were big plays. It was a long run. I had to run down there, get a block for him, and then the second play, he just scored a touchdown. He made it look easy. Every touch he got, he made it look easy.
Well, you know, it means a lot, you know, coming off the loss for Tulane. But, you know, we just keeping it a game at a time, you know, keeping the main thing the main thing.
What did you see on the interception you got?
I was just playing my half, even though we was in cover two. And then, you know, I'm reading the quarterback eyes, and, you know, I just broke on it as soon as I saw him release it. And then I just tried to make a play.
You guys had trouble getting off the field in the first half. What was going on?
We were just getting to feel it out, you know. It was a slow start for us too as well, but you know, as long as we kept getting three and outs and kept getting the field goals, we was gonna be okay.
What about the play with the fumble in the end zone? I guess you kind of had him run legs and Jaden hit him. What'd you see on that play?
I was playing my man at first, and then I see him broke out, so I knew I had to secure a tackle. But when I secured, I seen Jaden come over and then he fumbled. So you know, it was a good play for us, and it helped us out on offense.
Cycle of being back at home in front of your home fans and your first game, what does it mean to you and the team
moving forward? It was a great win, being at home in the win, just the momentum and all the exposure we get, you know, just trying to put on for our fans and show them that, you know, just one game is just about us. It's just a great win.
Yeah, just first off, I just want to say just the ability that the Lord gave me to play this game, I just want to give the glory to him and just the movement that he's doing on this team and on this campus is just amazing. Just the movement that our love for Christ, and it can just translate to the game. So I just want to say that first. But what was your question? I'm sorry.
Just your overall assessment of the game, which is the performance of the defense. Honestly.
Yeah, just the question you just asked, Yam, just slow start. I think it's just our ability just to do your job. Everybody has a role. You're one of 11 on the defense. Do you have to do nothing extra? You don't have to do – I don't have to do the mock position. I don't have to do my bandit position or the free safety. I have to do my position only, and everybody else has to do that as long as well, and all the pieces will fall in together. If you don't do your job, then it's a big bust, and as you can tell, that's how it's rolled for us. Just the big explosive plays that we have to eliminate within good teams that are critical and tight, like Tulane last week, and you just have to – you can't have explosive plays. You have to eliminate those.
What was the halftime like? Seemed like you guys came out with a lot more fire.
Yeah, halftime. Just the camaraderie, like I was saying, just with this team that we can have together, that we just have to build together. We just can't let situations like that. We just have to play the next play and brush it off and just put those play behind us, but yet don't put them all the way behind us. Look back on them, reflect on those, but yet play the next play with the attitude and effort that we know we can have, and just that urgency that we can play just dominant defensive football, which we've shown that we can do, and just continue just to do that over and over again.